Hello friends, welcome to Manimatu with Vinay. In this video, I'll be explaining types of orders and which type of order we have to use to get a more margin in intraday. Okay, so let's start with options because I generally give more option calls in intraday. So positional also I give. So if you follow my Telegram channel, you will get a clear picture there. So now, if you see my screen, I have already added 21,800 PE. It is trading, it is closed at 277.80. Let's consider it as 280. So because it will be easy to calculate. So as soon as you click on this, you get two types. One is buy, another one is sell. So retail trader can only buy because buying, to buy an option we need less premium, to sell an option we need more margin. So I'll show you the difference. Okay, so if you're buying, so here once you click on buy, you'll have two product type. One is normal, another thing is MIS. So MIS means intraday, normal means cash and carry. So once you buy any option or any stock in normal, so you can carry forward. If it is an option, so there is a expiry period for this particular option. 28th is the expiry. So till this Thursday, you can carry forward this particular option. If you are buying this particular option at 280 rupees. Okay, so just go to bottom, click on refresh. So you would need 6,945. So let's consider this as 7,000 rupees. Okay. You should have 7,000 rupees cash in your trading account to buy this particular option. Okay, let's say if you don't have that much cash in your trading account, at that time what you can do is you can click on MIS. If you click on MIS, you have another two varieties in intraday. One is bracket order, another one is cover order. Okay, so in bracket order, as soon as you click on bracket order, you will have two options. Automatically it opens up. One is stop loss, another one is target. So in bracket order, you can mention your stop loss, also your target. Let's say if you're buying this particular option at 280 rupees, you can keep stop loss and target together. Okay, for this particular order, you would need 4,861, which means 5,000 rupees. If you buy in a normal, you would need 7,000 rupees. If you are buying same option using bracket order, which means in intraday, you would need only 5,000 rupees. Okay. Let's go to cover order. So cover order also, same margin required to place bracket order or cover order. But if you use MIS, so this is the disadvantage of, see, anyway we'll be trading in intraday. Okay, for that, instead of using MIS, it is better to go with bracket order or cover order. But there is an advantage and disadvantage in these two. In bracket order, you can put stop loss, also target. But in cover order, you can only put stop loss, you can't put a trigger target in this particular order. So what you have to do if you are buying in cover order means, let's say your order is already executed at 280. Okay, you will have only one order that will be pending. Okay, so there it will be 250 rupees because we have kept 30 point stop loss for this particular order. So once trade is in your direction, let's say this option is moving from 280 to 300 rupees. What you have to do is from 250, you have to trail your stop loss from 250, 260, 260 to 265, 265 to 270, 280, 290. Like this, you have to trail your, manually you have to trail your stop loss in cover orders. But in bracket order, what you can do is you can keep your stop loss. Let's say same 20 points stop loss, same 20 points target, you can keep and you can forget it. Okay, whichever side it hits, order will get executed. Let's say if it goes below, If 260 hits, your order will get executed. If 300 rupees hit, your order will get executed. But simultaneously, you can trail your stop loss and trail your target together. I mean, simultaneously, you can do in both the cases. Same thing, trigger pending will be there. But the problem is, here you have to trail both. You have to trail your stop loss and you have to trail your target to get more profit. But in cover order, you will have only one order, so there will be no confusion. It is better to go with cover order instead of going with bracket order. Okay, in bracket order, we have one more option, that is trailing stop loss. So instead of trailing manually, as I said, you can trail your stop loss. Let's say if trade is in your direction, with how many points it has to move. If it is going in your direction, it will be trailed by 5 points. So in same scenario, in MIS only, we have market order, limit order. So market order means, make sure while buying anything, it may be equity, future, options or anything, make sure you have clicked on limit. So in limit order, you can customize the price. So you can buy the price which you want to. Let's say option is trading at 277, I want to buy at 275. So you can customize this. So you can buy the price which you want to. But if you click on market, so you will not have this editing option only. Okay, whichever price the seller is selling, you will get at that price. So you will not have any option to customize or change the price. So make sure you're clicking on limit order. Let's say if you're buying huge quantity, at the time you can select market order and buy. So let's come to equity. So in equity, same thing, position basis, like if you want to keep it for 10 days, 15 days, 30 days, at that time you have to click on CNC. As soon as you click on CNC, again you will have market order, limit order. So market order means the price people are selling at higher price. So market order means always you will get at higher price. Now Reliance is trading at 2091, someone would be selling at 2095. So we'll not be sure at which price our order gonna execute. So be careful while placing an order. Make sure you're buying at limit order itself. If you are very sure, at that time you can buy at market price. Okay, so if you click on mark limit, then you can modify the price. So I want to buy at 2090. Just mention the quantity. I have already mentioned it at 100. Okay, so for CNC, you can put stop loss as well as target. But in this case, you can't mention the price. You have to mention your stop loss and target in percentage. Okay, suppose you're buying Reliance shares 100 quantity at 2090, you want to keep 10% as your stop loss. Okay, you have to mention minus 10%, then it will treat this as a stop loss. 2090 into 10 divided by 100, so 209 would be your, which means 1881 would be your stop loss. Let's say you're keeping same 10% target, 2090 into 10 divided by 100. So 209 upper side, 2090. So 2299 would be your target. So once you place this order, whichever hits first, 2299 or 2299, whichever hits first, it will get executed. So once your order get executes, what you can do is, similarly you can trail your stop loss and trail your target also, once trade is in your direction. Okay, so what you can do is, see, as I mentioned, if you want to buy 100 shares of Reliance, you would need this much margin. So 2 lakhs margin required to buy in cash and carry. Same thing, if you want to buy in MIS, you would need 22,000. In BO, 13,000. In CO also same thing. So if you are trading, I mean if you are an intraday trader, you can use cover order to get a more margin. So you can easily, if you have 15,000 rupees, you can easily buy 100 quantity of Reliance. So any share, not only Reliance, any share. Okay, HDFC is trading around 1032. If you want to buy 100 shares in a cover order, you would need 5564 rupees, and it also goes with, let's say, 1000 rupees SL. See, 5,500. If you have 5,500 rupees, you can buy 100 quantity of HDFC Bank. Okay, if you are using BO, same thing. But same thing, if you want buy in cash and carry means you would need 1 lakh rupees margin. So because CNC, Zerodha or any platform, they won't provide any margin for cash and carry orders. So if you are an intraday trader, trade with cover order. If you have a limited capital, it is better to use cover order and get a more margin.